Postinfectious hydrocephalus is a significant problem in infants in sub-Saharan Africa. Ventricular peritoneal shunts, or VPS, are the standard treatment of postinfectious hydrocephalus. But endoscopic third ventriculostomy, combined with choroid plexus cauterization, or ETV-CPC, has been introduced as an alternative. ETV is accomplished by passing an endoscope through the anterior fontanelle and puncturing the floor of the third ventricle to create an internal path for drainage of cerebrospinal fluid. Cauterization of the choroid plexus is an adjunct procedure to reduce the production of CSF. VPS is technically straightforward, has a lower early failure rate than ETV-CPC, and typically results in a greater reduction in ventricle size. But does this lead to better cognitive development? There are also more failures later in childhood with VPS, requiring emergency surgery to fix shunt malfunction, a particular problem in low-resource settings where there is limited access to immediate neurosurgical care. In this trial in Uganda, 49 infants were randomized to receive VPS and 51 to receive ETV-CPC as treatment for post-infectious hydrocephalus. The primary outcome was the Bayley Scales of Infant Development Cognitive Scaled Score 12 months after surgery. The median cognitive score at 12 months was higher in the infants who received ETV-CPC than in the infants who received VPS, 4 versus 2. Despite a significantly smaller median CSF volume in the infants who received VPS, there was no significant difference in the number of infants who achieved normal brain volume at 12 months. Similarly, there was no significant difference in the number of treatment failures between the two groups. The authors conclude that there was no difference in cognitive outcomes between ventriculoperitoneal shunts and endoscopic third ventriculostomy combined with choroid plexus cauterization in infants in Uganda with post-infectious hydrocephalus. The study may not have been large enough, however, to exclude small differences in cognitive outcomes between the two forms of treatment. Full trial results are available at NEJM.org.